the host of Unfiltered, Dan Bongino, and correspondent at large, Geraldo Rivera. You know, I think, Geraldo, the issue of vaxxed and unvaxxed, that debate is over. Everybody's made up their mind. I don't think you're going to convince many people on that issue. You see now military, nurses, cops, firemen, first responders, they're willing to leave their jobs, abandon their salary, benefits, and pensions because of what they believe in. The question to me is, why, if we're going to follow science and we want to be safe, why is there no attempt at all to accommodate, especially nurses that were diving on COVID grenades every day, those people that might have natural immunity, a rare medical condition, or a different point of view? Why can't we accommodate them and keep the workplace safe and give the option of being tested? Why don't we, are we giving up all medical privacy, freedom, and doctor-patient confidentiality in this country? Geraldo, that's a high price.
You know, Sean, Aaron Rodgers, Shailene Woolley, one of my favorite couples. He's a terrific football player. He's a great personality, MVP. But he may have cost his team the Super Bowl last Sunday against Kansas City Chiefs. They lost, the Green Bay Packers lost 13-7 because he could not play, because he was positive and had lied to his teammates, lied to the city of Green Bay, lied to the people of this country about his status. And Sean, I think that just because he's popular, just because, and I don't want to join any mob.
You're not answering my question.
I'm not in any mob. This guy did not tell the truth to people that he loved. Let me finish, Sean.
But wait a minute. Are we giving up all medical privacy, all doctor-patient confidentiality, and all freedom? Whether you agree or disagree.
If I think that you cannot have a right of privacy, that I'm in your room with my grandchildren who are not vaccinated because they're too young, and you lied about your vaccine status and you sneeze on my grandchildren, you know, that could be a crime. That is absolutely so selfish and self-involved. And it, you know, I look at Aaron Rodgers and he's so charming. And again, I say I'm a big fan of his. He's a very, very agreeable, charismatic person. And he married a great actress. And I wish them all the best.
Let's go to Dan and get Dan's point of view.
And his apology was a bunch of baloney. I regret that, oh, if you think this way and that way. You know, he didn't say I'm sorry.
So you're not going to accept his apology.
He didn't say I lied.
Okay, fair enough. You don't have to. Dan Bongino.
That wasn't an apology.
Now, he doesn't owe anybody an apology. Aaron Rodgers doesn't owe Geraldo or anyone else jack squat. Aaron Rodgers was given his body by God. He is ward of his own body. Whether he chooses to disclose his immunization status or not isn't Geraldo or anyone else's business. And the other point here about you don't have a right to privacy if you sneeze around someone. Really? I mean, so we're throwing the Constitution out the window for a virus with the survivability rate of between 98 and 99%? I mean, really, if that isn't the road to tyranny, I don't know what is. I mean, are you going to apply the same tactic to people who are infected with tuberculosis? I mean, what about HIV? You know, it's interesting. Are you going to ban them from sexual contact, from intravenous drug use? What about tuberculosis? Are they not going to be allowed to breathe in public? You know, you see how these simpleton views of how privacy and the Constitution, by the way, which is not a suggestion, the Constitution is not a suggestion. It's our founding document. You see how that all gets thrown out the window when we go down this slippery slope? And it's all based on nonsense. They'll throw out the 1905 Jacobson case, which was a case based on smallpox in Massachusetts and the equivalent of a $125 fine. It's nothing to do with coronavirus and you losing your livelihood. It's all nonsense.
There have been three Supreme Court cases already that gave the government the right to mandate. In Maine, in Indiana, and in New York. The Supreme Court will soon deal with this Fifth Circuit case and will even it all out. Mandates are constitutional.
We don't know that yet. The Fifth Circuit, as they're saying, we will find out. But here's my question. There's got to be a way, if I'm right, if the premise of my question is right, that everybody's decided. People have made a decision. Especially when we're firing nurses that worked in a petri dish for 2 years at the worst moments of this pandemic, many of whom got COVID, and they believe in natural immunity. There's some disagreement on some of these issues. Where is the flexibility? Why is there a rigidness? You must get the vaccine or you're fired. How about vaccine, or would you agree to be tested so people don't lose their salary, their benefits, and their pension? Why is there only one size fits all medicine here?
You know, Sean, in January, I lost a beloved nephew, Bobby Reed, to this disease. He left
I've
his
lost
wife,
friends
Michelle,
too. It's horrible.
And his children, Tyler and Casey, lost to this awful disease that has already claimed 750,000 American lives.
Can
over
we
5
meet
million
in the middle
worldwide.
And find
at
an accommodation?
At what point? No,
or not.
There is no accommodation.
I despise,
let me be very frank, I despise vaccinated people who are smug in their protection, who urge unvaccinated people to exercise their freedoms.
What if they get tested
every
day?
You're not
even, even if they got tested every day, that's not good enough for you.
It's like the guy in the street who's telling the guy on the ledge to jump.
All right, last word, Dan Bundy.
You know, it's interesting. Geraldo, he despises these people, yet he doesn't know them. Like, I spoke to a guy who was fired by a company I work for who has a serious problem with blood clots, whose doctor told him if he gets the vaccination, he could be in serious medical trouble. Geraldo doesn't have a medical degree, he doesn't know, but he despises the guy he hasn't even met. And he paints that as a reasonable, rational decision. Geraldo hasn't met these people he despises, yet he despises them. Here's the thing. I don't despise anyone. I respect your individuality and your ability to make your own decision with your doctor.
You have no individual rights when it comes to the vaccine. You have no rights.
All right. Thank you both.
That's what tyrants say all the time, Ned.
When we come back, straight ahead.